A little check of our weather forecast here locally in West Michigan. Quiet weather. The winds have really toned down. Had some breezes earlier around 15 to 20, gusting to 25, even 30 miles per hour. But we're down in the range of about 5, 6, 7 miles per hour at this point out of the southeast. That same direction will be around tomorrow. And a southeast wind when you are in a very warm air mass, again, for the season, very warm. Running in the upper 60s to around 70 degrees. That takes the mild air, the warm air, all the way to the lakeshore. So anticipate that to be the case for tomorrow. We've only got high clouds passing on by. Absolutely no threat of any rainfall here tonight, nor for the bulk of tomorrow. As we get into tomorrow evening, a slight chance for some showers to emerge on the scene. More on that to come. Here were the daytime highs today. 66s, 67s, and even higher around the region. As you can see, no 70s actually, in fact, but did get to 69 in Grand Rapids. That was one of the highest numbers on the board, tied up with Benton Harbor down to the south over towards Detroit. What did they see? Well, they saw 70 degrees, 71, in fact, at the airport, Detroit Metro on the other side of the state. Where's our average at this time of year? 47 degrees. So the mathematics on that says we were 22 degrees above normal for this time of year. You might think, well, that had to be pretty close to a record. Wasn't. Not even close. 85 degrees we got to in 2012. That was part of that that stretch of just amazing warmth and unheard of warmth, really, that we made it into the mid to upper 80s for a stretch there of about 3 or 4 days, if you recall that. Just 9 years ago, the record overnight low at 6 degrees. That's a pretty healthy spance of, you know, just a huge spance of 85, 6 degrees. I mean, that's a massive difference. This time of year, you can get really warm and really cold. So we're on the warmer side of things, and that's good, because as each and every day that goes by, we're not going to have that opportunity to get as cold, you know, for the possible low point. And once you get into April, I mean, it's just hard to get down into the 20s and 30s at that point. And I don't see anything like that in the offing, but there is a little bit of a cool down as we get close to next weekend. Another warm one coming on Tuesday, and then a couple showers later tomorrow night into early on Wednesday morning. This is going to be a minor league system for us. It is this one down here late Thursday into Friday that I think we've got a better shot to really turn soggy. And at this point, we could use that rain. So I think that that's the time frame to look for, more so than tomorrow night's just kind of dampening of the ground around here. It's late Thursday into Friday where we could get about an inch, inch and a half of rain if everything works out just right. Look at this day planner, though. 49 is where we start. It's going to be mild, and those temps will move up quickly. We were at 63 degrees at midday today. I think we're even higher tomorrow. Some filtered or dim sun during the morning will transition towards mostly cloudy skies in the afternoon. We'll keep it on the warm side on Wednesday. With that system that comes through tomorrow night, that's not going to change the air mass up, because that system goes so far out to the west that the next one that comes is going to have to be the one to pull down the cooler air, and it will do so later Thursday into Friday. 45 for a high, as we'll have rain-cooled air around, though it'll probably stop raining early in the afternoon. Saturday back to 52 with a little sun, and then a system overnight Saturday to Sunday produces another shower or two, turns us cooler for a couple days stretch into early next week. Here's the look around the Midwest. There are some returns of sprinkles to our northwest, but most of this not reaching the ground. It is along that front where that first low pressure is going to track out to our west. Watch the European model takes the heaviest of the rain out through Iowa, Minnesota, and Wisconsin. But on the eastern extent of it tomorrow night, say after around 8-9 o'clock, we get a couple showers, light ones overnight into Wednesday morning. That'll clear out of here by Wednesday afternoon, go dry for the bulk of Thursday, I'm thinking. Now, a lot of this is overdone on the model on Thursday, but a system coming up from the Gulf of Mexico will have copious amounts of water with it, and I think we turn quite wet. And then that other one over the weekend could bring another shower overnight Saturday into Sunday. Look at these temperatures, though. Derek and Janice, we've been pretty spoiled recently, well into the 60s. It's got to come down just a bit. It's going to do that by the weekend. Temps in the 40s.
Do.
Okay.
Well, after 21 months off, high school spring sports.